If we can move now to agenda item 9, which is pages 69 to 78. Matthew, could we have a presentation, please?
Planning Commission has sought for the erection of a three-storey building with retail use at ground floor and residential use above, with six apartments proposed for the first and second floors. Although the site is currently vacant, a three-storey building occupied the site at one time, but was demolished following a fire in October 2009. The site has remained vacant since. The proposals being brought forward are a contemporary and modern development, which is considered will introduce a focal point in this prominent location, being located on the corner of Elm Road North and Woodchurch Road. The redevelopment of the site will be a welcome improvement in terms of the environmental quality of the street scene. The contemporary and modern design of the proposals would not harm the character of the area and would not appear incongruous in the street scene. The palette of materials proposed will ensure an attractive modern addition to the street scene. The proposals would not detrimentally impact on natural daylight into adjoining properties. The proposed new building will be flush with others adjacent to it on Woodchurch Road and ground floor, but will sit forward at first and second floors by some 0.7 metres. This will not result in any loss of light to windows at first and second floor of adjacent properties. All standard interface distances are achieved and off-street parking is proposed to the rear of the site. The scale and appearance of the proposed development are considered to be acceptable, and the redevelopment of this site with commercial units at ground floor and residential above is not out of keeping with the immediate environment. Conditions are proposed that deal with materials, detailed layout and provision of car parking and cycle parking, and hours of operation of the ground floor uses. The proposals are considered to be acceptable and are recommended for approval. There is no qualifying petition or objection in connection with this application.
Okay, and I can see that we don't have a ward councillor here either. Can I just ask before opening this up to committee, on page 75, paragraph 5, it talks about the agent was advised to make some minor changes, however, this was not acted upon. Can I just ask officers to clarify for me?
Thank you, through you, Chair. We did ask the agents or the applicants to set this part of the applications, the proposal on Elm Road North, slightly further back into the site, so that it was in line with properties further up Elm Road. But the agent declined to take that offer up, and notwithstanding that, we didn't feel that there was sufficient grounds to warrant a recommendation for refusal on that basis alone.
Okay, thank you. Stuart?
Thanks, Chair.
However, just sit forward
in a manner that I think is overdominant to the street scene, both at first and second floors, and then goes beyond the roof line to a flat roofed development. I think that, in addition to the lack of the aid of the applicants following the building line in North, strikes me as a development that does not sit well within the environment of that street scene. And as such is contrary to a number of the policies that are laid out at pages 72 and 73 of the report at SH1, for example, which is the criteria for development in the town centre. Specifically asks for the siting, scale and design and choice of materials not to be detrimental to an area. And I would suggest the way it sits forward with the existing building line at first and second floor is detrimental to that street scene. And similarly, so far as the residential developments, the residential aspect of it, it falls foul of exactly the same criteria in HS4. That's why we have a lot of it at home. Our members have it on the screen. They can see that not so well in that street scene. And a few further tweaks to it, I think, by the applicant would probably make it. It is a key site as you enter the church, enter the shopping area, and I just think it looks completely out of place, and we should refuse it under SH1 and SH4, and I do have words that I'll put forward if others want to make a contribution.
Denise? Been an eyesore on the road, and it's been so dangerous. It must have cost the council a fortune to look after this piece of land because they have to fence it off. The bollards that are there, that's because they come from the park and on the land, and then they just drop onto a church road in the traffic. I don't know if there's ever been a collision. I don't know how there hasn't been, because they just scream across the pavements and down onto a church road. I mean, I know the residents for a long, long time have wanted something there in replacement, obviously for date books and post office. But I'll just listen to the debate, Chair.
Can I take Treena?
Yes. So the residents are wanting something, obviously it was an eyesore beforehand, and obviously wanting something there, some description. I mean, this is, to me, does look out of keeping with the rest of the buildings. I mean, is there any way that this application could go back? I mean, I don't know what the grounds refusal is. I'd be interested to hear that, whether or not they could go back and have a look at with it, you know, being within more keeping of existing buildings.
Sorry, obviously, in order to do that, then we would have to refuse the application.
Yeah.
Okay.
Steve? Well, I'm not prepared to refuse the application on the basis of this slight bit that's between. Gone sites often are slightly and slightly different in design of a terrace. It is a modern building, and perhaps if we did ask them to step back, that would affect the size of the apartments, which we have many debates about in this kind of committee about, you know, decent sized apartments and not restricting the living space. So I think it's semantics. I think it would get knocked back on appeal, given the evidence to have to give it. So if there's a reason for refusing based on the streets, as that vote against them.
Okay, does anyone else want to make any comments before I go back to Stuart? Sorry, Pat.
Stuart is saying is that if you tweak this a bit, it would be
does look well out of keeping with the existing street scene. I think, you know, if the applicant is listening, I would just like them, you know, to modify it a bit, set it back a bit, change the roof line, and then we could approve it.
Okay, Stuart,
can
you go to
move
refusal, please?
Yes, I try to allude to the reasons for refusal in that it looks out of place and out of character of the area. I mean, most members will know it's a major thoroughfare through town, motorway into town. That block is a mirror image of the next block down. And the end property that was burned down, as it turned out, it was like a bookend to the other. So it looks, they have like two blocks which were almost identical. Now, I appreciate you're not going to be able to replicate it exactly, and I don't think we need to insist on that. But as it stands, as effectively just a square sitting on the site, it is completely out of keeping. And would that we could, you know, tweak it ourselves, say, but we can only improve or refuse the application. In terms of, Pat Cleary's right, just because we've waited for a long time doesn't mean that we should accept the person that comes along. And there have been 18 objections received to the development. That having been said, then, I would move the reason for the refusal that the proposed development would form a visually intrusive feature by reason of its size and scale, which the local planning authority considers will be out of keeping and detrimental to the general character of the street scene of Woodchurch Road and Elm Road North. The proposed development would therefore be contrary to criteria 1 and 2 of policy HS4, so far as it relates to the housing element of the scheme, and criteria 4 of policy SH1, so far as it relates to criteria 4 of the development in a key town centre. The two policies of the adopted Wirral Community Development Plan and the principles of the National Planning Policy Framework. I will move that.
Thank you, Stuart. Is there a second then? Thank you, Pat. All those in favour of refusal? Against?